are generally the animals which we grow them at home. Okay, fine. So pets can also be seen on farms. Okay, but pet animals are which we have them inside our home, and farm animals are the thing which are grown or seen in the farms and the fields. Okay, yes. So how does a farm and maths fit together? We will try to see. Okay, that will be very fun and interesting, I'm thinking. But anyways, let's wait and we will see what else do we know. Okay, on farms, what all we'll see? Animals, we'll see. What else do we see on farms?
Mom, we see some nice vegetables, crops,
fruits,
easy crops,
and grain pulses.
Farmers, water, mud.
Wow, so many. That's it.
Vegetables, fruits
on the farm.
Vegetables, we'll see there. And we'll see crops, and we'll see animals. And we'll see, I think we'll see some birds also.
Yes, that's really nice. And even if you know, we even see ponds, lakes, and rivers also, right, near to farms?
Yes.
Yes. So when it is a farm, imagine a farm will be really beautiful, right? With green crops and many different animals and a river, pond, and so many things like that. Okay. And before we start the story, I want you people to get a pencil and a paper. So anything if you would like to draw during the story also, you can go ahead and draw. And if I ask you to draw or write something, you can do that. Okay. So please keep your paper, pencil, and colors if you want to ready. Fine. And yes, so many people are joining. That's good to see so many. And that too for a story. Yes, that's nice. So all of you like stories?
Yes.
Yeah, I also like stories. Yes. And if you have attended my earlier story session, I've already told you people, I guess. Who is an author?
Who writes a story?
That's correct. Yes. The person who writes the story is called an author. And who is an illustrator?
Who draws the picture
in the story?
The person who draws the picture.
Yes, that's correct. Yes, thank you, Sarah. Yes, an illustrator is a person who draws the artwork, the paintings or the drawings which you see in the book, according whether it is a story or poem. Yes, that person is called an illustrator. And okay, then who am I?
Mom, you are an author.
No, I didn't write the story, but I will try to one day.
Illustrator?
Illustrator is the person who draws. I draw, but not for a story. So I'm
a teacher.
Yes, thank you. Yes, I am a narrator or a storyteller. Okay, storyteller is a person who tells stories. Narrator is also a person who reads the stories. Okay, so it's similar. And can anyone tell me who is the first storyteller for anybody? Anybody? Who is the first storyteller?
Mother.
Yes, that's right. For almost everyone, right? Our parents, our mom is the first storyteller. So, you people like your mom's stories or not?
Yes.
So, yes. What I want all of you kids to do is go to your mom today after the session and tell her that, Mom, you are the first storyteller for me and thanks a lot. Would you do that for me?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Please make your moms happy. They would have told you some hundreds of stories till date, right? So, after the mother, who else tells the stories? Our parents, our relatives, friends and everybody. And today, I'm a storyteller. I'm going to tell you the story. So I think we have everybody, and I am going to tell a story about maths in a farm. So shall we go ahead and see?
Yes.
Yes. I'm going to share my screen. Okay. Anytime if you think you're not able to see or any disturbance, please type it in the chat box. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So what do you see over here in the picture?
A farm.
I see
a farm.
I see a boy and a girl. And some hens.
A boy and a girl.
Yes.
And three eggs.
Oh, you're so specific, Pranvi, for telling me the number also. That's right. Thank you, Itanshan. Thank you, everybody. Yes. We do see a boy and a girl. And the girl is trying to write something with the chalk over there. And I think even the hens are interested to see what they're writing, right? See how the hen is looking at it. The different numbers. So the first image, Yes. And what is the story name? This is how you...
This is how you count eggs.
Yes. Thank you for reading it out. This is how you count eggs. So that means they are trying to count the eggs it seems. Okay. On a farm. How do they count? Do they have a technique or they just keep counting 1, 2, 3 and all? Let us go ahead and see. And as you people have already told me, the author, the person who wrote this story is Aparna Atreya. And the person who drew this beautiful, beautiful, colorful pictures is Swati Agarwal. Okay? So let us go ahead into the story. Kavya was 6 years old. She loved to chase birds and feed cows on the farms. Good morning! She shouted on a Sunday morning. That means she's very excited, right? How you said it's a wonderful Saturday. Kavya loves a Sunday. So as soon as she woke up, she was so happy that she shouted, good morning. And what does she love to do? She likes to
chase birds.
Thank you. Yes. So because on a farm there are animals also, and the animals are the birds and the cows. So she likes to chase the birds and feed cows on the farm. And how does the farm look? Beautiful, right? With the greenery and all the sky and all.
There is more trees and grasses.
Yes. So now, here, Kavya, come here, called out her grandma. Could you help Prabhu collect and count the eggs, please? So on the farm, can you see how the house is over there? Not like our regular walls and all, right? In a farm, the houses will be pretty different, which are made of coconut leaves or something and with wood and all, okay? So this is a farm where Kavya is living with her grandmother and her brother. So now what is grandmother asking? She's asking for help. So if your grandmother or anybody asks you for help, would you help them or not?
Yes, we can help them.
That's right. Thank you for showing your thumbs up also. Yes, you have to help them because helping is a good habit, right? And yes. Anybody, no need to raise your hand to speak. You people can directly unmute your mic and talk to me, or else you can show your thumbs up or your thumbs down. Okay? No need to raise your hands. Thank you. So now let us see what is Kavya going to do. So we see the hens and the cows also, right? Yes. And now what is happening over here? They are inside the farm, hen farm. So the hens are there and the eggs and everything is there. And what other animal is over here?
There is a dog and hen.
And what is the dog having in his mouth?
Yes.
Dog is running and that's a slipper. Raghu began to count the eggs. 1, 2, 3, 4, till 14 he went. And then what happened? The dog is running away with slipper. So what did he do? He stopped counting and he's like, see now, drop my slipper now. Don't take it and go. So now what happened? So does Raghu remember till where he counted?
No, we will lose track, right?
That is very
when
that's right. He'll forget.
Count addition.
Yes, you people can see the number here 14, but Raghu, while he's counting, he stopped counting and he's like, don't run away, Sina. So he stopped counting. Uh-oh. So again, what does he have to do? He start to count again from 1, right?
1. Yeah.
Yeah. And now here in the picture, whom do we see?
A boy.
Yes.
And a bicycle and one man.
Correct. There's a bicycle and a boy. And what is he doing? He's trying to touch the bicycle. And now what is happening? So he stopped counting, right? Raghu started counting again. 1, 2, 3, 4 and everything. And now what happened? 12, 13. Ayo, I counted till 13 or 12. He forgot. So he started counting again. And then he saw his friend touching his bicycle. And that guy's name is Puneet. Puneet, don't touch my cycle. He shouted. Now what happened? So now again, what is happening? Does Raghu remember how many he counted?
No.
He forgot how much he counted.
Again, he stopped counting and again he'll forgot. Ayo, that is what he's saying. 1, 2, 16. Till now though, he counted till 16, but he forgot. and he touched his cycle. Okay, do we have to shout when somebody touches our things?
No.
If we can calmly tell them, right?
No.
Okay, yeah. Don't touch. But when you're doing something and somebody interrupts, what will happen? We will forget what is happening. And now Raghu has to count from the start all over again, right? And counting is really difficult, no? Again, from one,
two, three.
Yeah, he has to keep counting and counting. And okay, yes?
It will be taking time.
I know, it's pretty time taking, right? Let us see. Yeah, it is taking time. And yes, okay. And in this picture, what else are you able to see? What are these cone, glass shape of things? What are those?
There is...
Mom,
there is food or water for the hens.
Wow, that's brilliant. That's correct. Thank you. At times, they can be lights also. But I think these are food grains and all. Yes, that's right. So now, what is happening? He again forgot. And he's like, now he's fed up. When he has to do it again and again and again, what happens? I don't want to do this now. I'll do it later. But Kavya, his sister came. Don't worry. There's a very easy way. I've learned it in school. So I will tell you how to count it. With that, you can count bigger numbers. And what is the bigger number? Up to crores can you count? Raghu is making fun of her. So when somebody is trying to help us, do we make fun of them? Is it a good habit?
No.
You can show your thumbs down also. Okay. Yes, that's a very bad habit. You are not supposed to make fun of people when they're trying to help you, right? Then Raghu is making fun. But then Kavya is a very good sister. So Kavya was not like that. She didn't get angry. Generally, people will get angry, right? But Kavya was very good. She's like, no. Counting up to 10 is easy. And later you can count it very easily. Add 10x to a basket, then put it aside. Then take another basket and put 10x. And like this, divide it into tens, group of tens, till you complete all the eggs. Oh, is it easy? Shall we go ahead and see whether it's easy or not?
Yes.
And if you see, does Raghu, is happy or is he looking? How is he looking?
Excited.
Surprise.
Surprise. He is either excited or surprised because he's thinking, how can we count so many eggs, like how Kavya is telling? Okay, anyways, let me wait and see what my sister is up to. He's thinking. And here in the picture, I think you can see there are so many baskets, and in all the baskets, eggs are there, right?
Broken.
Yes.
Oh, that's correct. So you have to be very careful while picking up the eggs.
Yes, we should be careful or it will be fall down and broken.
That's correct. So, and that too, when they're in a farm, when they're working, they have to have it even more careful. Otherwise, many eggs will break, right? After collecting the eggs, what do you think these people will do with the eggs?
They'll sell in the market.
Yes. They can only eat.
Okay, that's correct. They can eat. But I think there are too many of the eggs to eat, no? And that is a hen farm. So generally, when you're having a farm, you do that to sell. Okay. So yes, they will be selling and they'll be eating also. But which one they'll do, we will go ahead and see. But in the meantime, let us see how Kavya is going to help him count the eggs. Now, as Kavya said, Raghu, what did he do? He kept all the eggs in different baskets and he put everything. Now, Raghu is like, okay, my task is done. I've collected all the eggs. Now, can you tell me, how many do we have? So now Raghu is like, okay, can you go ahead and tell me? Now, let me show you how they'll do. Okay, let us see. This is our basket and we are having different eggs. Okay? So can everybody count with me how many are there?
Yes. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
So I have one basket with 10 eggs. Okay, like that, Raghu has kept many different boxes of eggs. And now he's asking Kavya, okay, now how do you tell? Then Kavya says, okay, now this is 10, right? So think it is 110. So instead of a box, I'll show you something else. So this is one basket, okay? This has 10. And this is another basket. How many this will have?
20.
Wow.
Correct. When you say something right, what am I supposed to do?
Yes.
So, one basket, two basket. Now, let me see how intelligent and fast you are. I am having four baskets of eggs. So, how many eggs do you have?
40.
Yes, that's a lot of explanation and perfect. Correct. That is 40 eggs. And if suppose I am adding two more baskets. So total how many?
60 baskets.
You people are really brilliant. So now you tell me, counting like this, 1, 2, 3 is easy or is this easy?
Ma'am, scale one.
So we will call this as 110 bar or 10 unit. Okay, we call this as a 10 bar. If you are using some materials, so people will tell that. So from now onwards, I think you can count very easily. Whenever your mom or your dad needs help, I think you will help them.
Yes,
correct. This is addition also. 10 plus 10 plus 10.
Subtraction.
Addition or subtraction.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Let me see how we can do subtraction. You people are really interesting. I mean, wow. You people are brilliant. Okay. Let me see. Okay. So, in the story so far, what we have seen, they have collected the eggs in the basket and they're trying to count. And you people have already helped me. So, let us see if we can work out subtraction also. So, how many are there?
60.
40.
All of them.
Look here. Yes, this is a 40. And if suppose I am removing 110 basket, how many are there?
30.
I thought
minus,
we can do
not plus.
Okay, sorry. Minus. Subtraction. That's correct. Thank you for correcting me. I thought only addition I can do with this 10 bars. We can do subtraction also. Subtraction.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you for helping me. I thought only addition we can do with this, but subtraction also. Thank you, kids.
Multiplication also.
Multiplication also. Oh, yes. Okay.
Fine. 10 to the 10 size.
Oh, right. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 10 bars into 4. What is this? 10 in multiplied
40,
by
4. 40. 40.
40.
40.
40 and...
Amazing. So, thank you. I thought only addition I can do, but you people taught me subtraction and multiplication also. I'm so happy. I thought I'm going to tell you a story, but you are telling me maths. That's brilliant. Intelligent students you are. Okay.
Like so, 7, 2, 14.
Yes, 2, 7, 14. But we are talking in terms of tens only, no? So I'll tell only about 10. Okay. So let us go and see into the story. What else is there? Whether we understood what you people told is right or not about Kavya and Raghu?
Yes.
Even I am interested whether they are so fast like you are not. Okay.
I'm also interested, ma'am.
Okay, just a minute. Are we able to see? Yes. Okay. So now we have seen that Raghu has collected all the eggs and he has put it into the baskets. Yes. Now, how Kavya will teach is similar to what you people have taught me is the same or not. So here, how many are there? Count and tell me. How
five
many baskets?
Five baskets.
Yes, but the symbol over here is addition, right?
Yes.
Less. So how many are there? Then Kavya immediately said, like you, very fast calculations you are doing. Even Kavya was like, immediately 50 eggs. Wow. How is that even happening? Very fastly she told, no? So let us see. Okay. Then they have completed counting all the eggs. And now grandmother is very, very happy to see that everything is counted. And grandmom is asking them, how did you count so many eggs so fastly? Then Kavya explained. How did she explain? Here, five baskets are there, right, Grandma? In each basket, there are 10 eggs. So 10x plus 10x plus 10x plus 10 plus 10 makes you 50 eggs. So that is how we counted. Grandmom is very, very happy, right? Because the counting. Yeah. So now what they have.
10 is 100.
10, if you add 10 times, it is 100. Okay. So now what did they do after collecting and counting all the eggs? Kavya and Raghu went to the market with Aji. So where did they go?
Market.
Yes.
Into the market.
Yes, to sell the eggs. And okay, in the picture over here, what animal do you see in the background?
Cow.
Yes, that's a cow. So cow is also a farm animal, right?
Yes.
So, okay. Now, yes, that's also a farm animal. And I want to show you something else before we proceed with the story. Can I go ahead and show something?
Yes.
Okay. So, how is this?
Super.
So, this is something I have brought to show you people. So, can you see? What are all the farm animals over here? We have a?
Cow, sheep, pig, duck, cow.
Yes, so these are all the different farm animals. And who did you see here? Who is this?
Kavya.
Yeah, and this is? So, how is this? Is it interesting to learn maths in a farm?
Yes.
I had a lot of fun. And let us see, they went to the market and they have tried to sell the eggs. What will happen also, we'll see. Okay? So, like this, you people also can draw anything if you are interested to. Okay? So, in that way, you can learn something about coloring and even different farm animals. Okay? So, that is how they are trying to count the eggs and everything. So, okay, you people told me, it means fields and all. And what is this?
Mom, it is a pond.
Lotus and a duck.
Yes, thank you, Priya, Lishcha, Brahmi,
Tansh. Duck is swimming. That is female duck.
Oh, female duck also. Thank you for that. Yes. So, in a farm, we do see fields where we can grow crops and also different farm animals from which we can, from hence we will take eggs from. Oh, please go. Thank you, Alicia. You can go ahead and draw. I'll ask your ma'am to share if you can. Then you can draw it. Okay. So from the farm animals also, we can get from cow, what can we get to sell?
Milk from cow.
Yes. Oh, Akshaya, thank you, Priya. Yes, Nitya, right. So, from the cow also, we get milk, right? We can sell that. Yes. And from sheep, we get the wool. Like that, from all the farm animals also, we get so many things. And they can sell and they can use something for that. Okay? So, that is one technique to count. To add, to subtract, and even multiplication. That's nice. So, let us see what happens in the rest of the story.
Yes.
So I've noticed that.
I'm excited to see the end of the
story. Oh, right. Even I am excited. Okay, but I've noticed that few people have just joined in. So I'll do a little recap of the story. Is it okay?
Yes.
Thank you. Okay. So I'll try to tell using this. So there is a farm where we have Kavya and Raghu. They are brothers and sisters. So they both are trying to collect the eggs from the farm. And Raghu is a little boy and he doesn't know how to count. What is happening is like he's trying to count the eggs, putting in a basket. And suddenly somebody is coming in, like somebody joined in the meeting. Now I have to admit them. Then I forget what I'm counting. So even Raghu forgot like that. Then Kavya is like, wait, Raghu, I'll try to tell you how to count. So what did Kavya say? Take a basket and put eggs in it. How many eggs?
10.
Yes. Yes, in one basket, put 10 eggs. And in another basket, put again 10 eggs. Like that, collect all the eggs and put it in different baskets. One basket, two basket, three basket. So, let me think that this is one basket, this is two basket, this is three basket. Now, now Raghu is like, okay, I'm done collecting. How many did he collect? 5 baskets, right? So, I'm having 5. So, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. Yes. Like that, when Kavya helped, Raghu immediately understood. Okay, so now the count is 50 eggs. So taking this 50 eggs, where did they go? To whom did they go?
They went to the market to sell eggs.
So the grandmother was strong. Yes, thank you. Yes, they have counted and they have to go to the market. Grandmother was surprised because she thought they will take a lot of time to count. But they counted very fastly, just like you people. And now grandmother took all those eggs to the market and they wanted to sell those eggs. Okay, as you are interested, even I am very excited. Yes, Tejas Nair, that's right. They have gone to the market. So let us see what is going to happen in the market. Okay?
Okay, ma'am. Can you show that drawing once again?
Okay, let me finish the story and then I'll show you. Is that okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, because we are almost at the end of the story. So let us complete and then I'll show you the drawing. You can draw it. No problem. So now they went to the market and they had a lot of fun selling the eggs. It is very fun to go to the market, right? So many people trying to sell so many things. Then, okay, now what do you think what happened here?
Ma'am, they have
they got some money.
Yes, that's correct. That's correct. Thank you. Yes, they have sold all the eggs and they've got a lot of money. And what do you think they're doing? They're bundling it up. And each bundle has how many notes do you think?
100.
Okay. Yes. Generally, if you are getting a bundle from a bank or outside, you will have hundreds only. But Kavya is a little girl who told to count in her own way. And how many do you think she will keep in a bundle?
10.
Yes. That's right. Yes, now she has kept everything in the counts of 10. So the bundles here will have only 10 notes, I guess, because she knows how to count to 10. So she has started taking the notes and she has put them in bundles of 10 and she can complete counting very, very easily. See, since she understood maths well and she liked the subject, she helped to count the eggs also. And now she's helping counting the
money also.
Money. Yes. That's correct. I think from now onwards, you people also will help your parents, right? If they ask you to?
Yes.
That's good. That's really good habit.
Subtraction or multiplication.
Yes. So with the 10 bars, we can do addition, multiplication and even subtraction. That's perfect. So they have helped. Kavya and Raghu have. Yes, that's right. It is easy and it is fast also, right? Yes. So now, they have completed counting the money also. And for dinner, they had rice and spicy egg sambar. Wow. So somebody told me that they can eat the eggs also, right? Yes, they did eat their own eggs also. So they did egg sambar. So they had rice and egg sambar after that. Wow. Right? So see, here. Now they're trying to show how you can count or something like that. Okay? So here we have one egg, one chicken and one basket. Okay. And a 10 is group of 10 ones, right? That is what we have learned. And now, okay. Now somebody can tell me how much is this? Flowers.
Oh my God.
11.
Yes. That first circle of flowers is 10 and plus 1 is 11. And here how many birds? How many birds?
12.
Yes, that's right. Because a 10 bar...
10 equals to 12.
Yes, 10 12. Plus 2 equals to 12. That's correct. And here, this one, how many?
23. 2 bundles of 10
plus 3 ones. That is 23.
Yes, that's correct again. So, I think now it's very easy to count, right? So, just group, make a group of 10s and then you can keep adding and adding and it will be very, very easy. Yes, so, that concludes our story. Okay? Yes.
Now, we can count with 100. 100 plus 100 is equal to 200.
Yes, that is also very easy. That's right. If you are having a 100 block, I guess they'll say that. So, it's just multiples of 10. So, if you think this is 100, okay, like how we said, 100 plus 100, how much?
200 plus 100 is equal to 300.
200.
100 100 plus 100 300
400
plus 4
300
100. Excellent. I'm having a lot of fun with maths today. You people are really, really very intelligent and super fast. I think you have a brain like a computer, right? Very fast and doing very good calculations. So you can do one thing. You can ask your mom or your dad to take some coins. You have so many games at home, so take some coins and show them this. They'll be very happy to see. Okay.
Yes.
How is the story? You people like the story?
I love it and it was so enjoying.
Wow, that's it. Thank you for telling me that. So, see, wherever you go or wherever you do something, if you try to learn something new, right, it will be very, very exciting. So, today, have you observed? We have learned two different subjects. What subjects did we learn?
One is about farming and one is about
maths. That's correct. So maths we have learned, in English we have read the story, and even about animals. So it can be social sciences, right? Yes, and environmental sciences also you people can say. So you have learned so many things in one class.
What is science, ma'am?
Environmental.
Can we show that drawing?
Can we tell that, right? Environmental sciences or social with animals? I don't know. Okay, that's just so many things. Okay, so somebody wanted to see the picture. May I show it again?
Yes.
So here is the picture. Okay, just let me turn my screen.
Little bit.
Okay.
Yes.
So this one I try to draw so that you people can see the very different animals.
Ma'am, please do a little bit on right.
Okay.
I can take screenshots.
Okay, fine. I'll ask your ma'am to send this, okay? Will that be fine with you? You can draw it and send to her later.
Okay, ma'am.
I will draw and send you.
Thank you. That would be really lovely. Okay, because during the class, we will try to talk, discuss and learn many things rather than just drawing, okay? So that later on when I send the picture, you people can happily draw, color it and send it back whatever pictures you draw. Okay? So that will make me really, really happy. Like that we can have so many stories and everything. If you like the story and if you want one more story, do tell. Okay? Then next time again, come with a very different story. And, okay, I've told you narrator and how many of you remember my name?
I like your story. One more story. Ma'am,
narrator is a person who narrates or tells us the story.
Yes, that is I am. And what's my name?
Ma'am, Padmalata.
Yes, thank you. Yes, I'm really happy to tell the story to you all kids. You're really brilliant and wonderful. So like this, we'll try to listen and learn more stories with many different things. Does that sound good?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Now, in the story, we have learned some moral values also, if you observe. Let me see what are those. Okay, if somebody wants to help you,
ma'am,
do you take the help or do you laugh at them?
Ma'am, if somebody
wants to
help you, so one good thing.
Help them.
Yes.
And they will give
and that help can be from your family or when you're outside playing, even your friends or your friends' moms also can help you. So never be angry or shouting at them. Okay. Always be soft and sweet. Okay. So even then they'll also feel happy. And what else did we see? If somebody is touching your thing, do you have to shout at them?
No. We have to tell calmly.
Exactly. So do you do the same thing or not? If you're not doing, try to learn at least from now. Okay. So whenever somebody is trying to take, suppose if I'm telling you a class, my daughter is there at the back and she's trying to pull my mobile. Do I shout at her? No, Rattle Seller, please, I'm having a class. Yes. So try to be a bit calm and talk nicely to your friends or mom or anybody. Okay. Don't be angry or shouting. That's not good for health. Okay. And suppose if your friend really wants his bicycle, right? What can you do? Please wait. I can share it with you. So sharing is a good thing.
Yes.
But when you are sharing your things, you have to. Yes.
When we share, they also share when we need help.
Yes, Akshaya Priya. Thank you. That's correct. So when you try to share something, they will also share something. How I'll tell you? I thought I know only addition with this. I told you. But I shared my information with you. Now, you people are really sweet. So you shared me your information about subtraction too. Right? So that is how we will learn a lot of things. So thank you for helping me. You people helped me. So I'll definitely say thank you. And I'm looking forward to see more things. So,
Mom.
Yes.
When you say the thing, you forget to when Kavya
yes.
say to help him, he get fun of him.
Yes, that's not a good thing, no, Nitya. So we are not supposed to laugh. Okay. So whenever somebody is helping us, we have to be happy about it, because sometimes if you are in danger or something also, nobody will help if you start laughing. So you have to be happy to help, and you people help me, so I'm happy. So that's why I'm saying thank you. And thank you is an appreciation word, right? So do you people know any more appreciation words?
Yes. Mom, welcome. Sorry. Thank you. Excuse
Mom,
me.
I'm sorry. Thank you. Excuse me.
Ah. Oh, that's good. So, shall I tell you a couple of more appreciation words?
Yes, ma'am.
So, when somebody does something, I ask you something, you people help me. So, immediately the first thing that comes to my mind is, thank you. Then, you can also say, well done, great job, excellent. Very good. Where do you see all this? Your homework books, right? Whenever you
absolutely.
Yes.
When you help someone with it, they will be saying this one.
Yes. Amazing. That is also they say. So,
or we do some works.
Yes, that's right. Whenever you do your work, that can be your homework.
Or when we tell some answers.
Excellent. That's right. When you say answers or when you do your homework on time, and when you listen also. Suppose your mom is like, now stop watching TV or playing with your friends. Go ahead and do your homework. If you do correctly what your mom says, she'll be happy and she'll be that's
very done. Excellent. Very good.
Yes. So these are appreciation words. Okay. So from now onwards, whatever it is, whenever somebody says something, try to be a bit polite. That will be
yes.
Yes, I know you people are very polite. How do I know? Do you know? When I'm telling the story also, you people did not disturb me at all. That's really good habit. Because if you disturb, what happens? Even I will forget what I am saying. Like how? Prabhu forgot what he's saying. Right?
So others can also get disturbed.
Yes, that's right. So you people didn't disturb me. You people didn't disturb the class. So that's a really good habit. Just wonderful. So all the kids, please keep doing that. And even in your school, try to follow the same rules. Okay? So, we are up with the time. And our story, this is how you answer. Okay? So, I'll see you again in another story session.
Mama, okay. When are you going to our teacher's them also?
I'm sorry, who was that?
When someone hurting us, they need help, we can help them also.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes. Whenever somebody asks for help, if you can do it, go ahead and do it. But if you, but because since you're little kids, no, do tell your parents before helping or doing anything. Don't just go ahead and do it. Sometimes it might be a bit dangerous. Okay. So, anyways, thanks a lot for attending this session today. So I enjoyed it a lot. So you all also enjoyed?
Yes. I was so enjoying.
That's nice to know. So again, I'll see you in the next session.
Enjoyed a lot.
Bye.
Thank you. Okay, bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye